Come, let us wet tongues about dreams. Those things you push aside for what seems to be a pursuit of a means to an end. So what happens when a means to an end comes to an end? Yes, I mean an end. You become an Alice in Blunderland, and your rabbit hole becomes an abyss which swallows up your bliss and spews out false hope. Like a one-eyed man who sees a silver lining in air pollution, wake up. It is not coffee you are smelling, no. Merely a mixed aroma of norms cooked by capitalists of yesteryear who auction out ambition, the souls who mistake a simple means to an end for immortality. So what will it be? The pursuit of haunting dreams? Or deep conversations about what could have been? See, I was sent to remind you that death is the flashlight at the end of a tunnel for those who defy truth, that only those who embrace courage will taste the fruits of victory. You see, courage is not the absence of fear, but the procession of movement amidst it. Yes, courage is not the absence of fear, but the procession of movement amidst it. See, I was sent to conscientize those who give wings to excuses, those who feed procrastination intravenously with suicidal risks, those who embrace common thinking at the expense of progression, those who sleep on feathered pillows, forgetting that those feathers are from their wings, those who pursue relationships with the same faith that was designed for the pursuit of their dreams. What will it be? See, I wish to ask fate if it believes in dreams. I'm seething, please, haunted by the images behind my eyelids. Every time I sleep, I realize that I have been sleeping on myself, counting sheep that wear the same face as I. I have been picking cotton for way too long, and I don't have a field to show for it. I woke up. It is not coffee I was smelling, no. It was the scent of my burning soul stuck in a corporate hole, but my dreams are pulling me out of it. And yes, I'm feeling out of it. I realize that I'm not out of gas. I simply use a new fuel now.